It's a cockroach.
Well, what's it doing in my breakfast?
Not a lot by the looks of things. It's dead.
Boom, boom! Huh?
You'd think that glass would be clean by now. He's been polishing it since the first episode.
Doesn't look happy, does he?
No. He's certainly not his chipper, slightly surreal self today, that's for sure. I say, Mr. Anil, you look like a man who's been chomping on a duvet.
Hey?
A little bit down in the mouth. Boom, boom! I say, this is serious. He always remembers to laugh at my jokes. He doesn't get paid otherwise.
Anil, is everything okay?
No. No, it's not. I have to say, things aren't looking too good. I've got serious problems.
Yes, we know, but we've always considered that part of your charm. How's it going with the shrink?
What do you think you're doing?
Sorry, Doctor. I'm not feeling myself today. Boom, boom!
No, I've got serious problems with the calf.
Things are bad, are they?
I'll say. There's this new place open down the road that's taking all my trade. Good food at reasonable prices, apparently.
Now there's a novelty for a calf.
Why haven't you thought of that?
Because I can't cook and I'm mean.
Well, I did ask.
I want my money back. This is inedible.
But you've eaten half of it.
Well, give me half my money then.
This is odd. Even by Mr. Anil's appalling standards. So you see, Mr. Anil is behaving most strangely.
And?
And what?
And what's new? He's always been a nutter. Can I go watch my video now?
But what about Mr. Anil?
He can rent it himself if he wants to watch it.
Oh, pop a socket at your stupid boy.
So, tell us what's wrong with Anil.
Well, rather than merely tell you, I can do better, and indeed show you. All thanks to our new flashy flashback machine.
And it really is a beauty, with over a million gigabyte hard drive, with a totally flexible digital software interface.
Now, take a look at this, what we recorded earlier.
I can't eat this.
Why not? Is there something wrong with your teeth, eh? This is a calf, not a dentist. Now, op it.
Excuse me. This meat, it's off.
I know. It's off a cow, or a chicken, or some sort of chewy fish. Now, can't you see I'm busy?
This alleged soup of the day.
What about it?
Could you tell me what day exactly?
Couple of weeks last Tuesday. Now beat it.
That's a bit much. Even for Anil.
Yes, rubbish food we expect, but this rudeness... Well, I mean, even I found myself on the receiving end of it. See what I mean?
Now, if you don't mind, I've got a calf to run.
Yes, but for how much longer?
You don't really think he could lose the cafe, do you?
What? Lose a great big hairy thing like a cafe?
Even Anil isn't that stupid.
Though he is making a spectacularly good job of losing his dwindling band of customers. Now, come on, Mr. Stephen. Time for us to get to the bottom of Mr. Anil's trouble.
Whoa! If it's his bottom that's troubling him, I, for one, am not going anywhere near it.
Mr. Anil, thought we'd found you here.
Yeah, that the only person you will find. Where am I going wrong?
How long you got? But I have to warn you, this is only a half-hour show.
I know food was never my strong point, but I seem to be getting worse at it. I don't understand. It's a mystery.
Well, that pizza certainly looks the business.
It is. Excellent. A perfectly baked dough with plenty of toppings. Very tasty.
I didn't know you did pizza.
I don't. I got takeaway. From that new place down the road that's nicking all my customers. Well, would you eat here? And no one in their right mind would either. Face it. I'm a complete failure.
Oh, we wouldn't say you're a complete failure, would we, Basil?
No, not a complete failure. I'm sure there's one or two recipes he hasn't ruined yet. Boom, boom!
Thanks for trying to cheer me up, guys. But I'm afraid it's just not working. Bit like me, eh?
Look, you've got to tell yourself it's just a blip you're going through.
Right. Anil? Yes, Anil. It's just a blip you're going through. Okay, if you say so, mate.
He really needs help.
Nice word, that. Blip. Blip. Blip, 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 blip,
really, really needs help.
Yeah, that's the spirit, Mr. Anil. Why, any moment now, a new customer could walk through that door and your fortunes could instantly change.
Yes!
And right on cue...
Orso.
Anil.
You're right. My fortunes have just changed.
Hooray!
For the worst.
Well, if it isn't my old school pal, Anil. Fancy running into you. Small world, isn't it?
Yeah. And it always seems an awful lot smaller when you're in it, you big fat lump.
Hey, Anil. You always were a joker, weren't you?
Hey, Orso, you always were a greasy, gut-churning bucket slug. What do you want?
Well, he wants to go on a diet for a start.
Hey, man. Just being neighbourly.
Neighbourly?
Did I mention? I opened a new restaurant down the road. Pizza's not bad, is it?
So it's you.
And I've got to tell you, business is terrific. How are you doing?
Oh, yeah, things are great. Yeah, really, really great. Aren't they, Basil?
What? Hey, yes. I think you'll find things around here are generally booming. Boom, boom.
Yeah. You're that fox off the box, aren't you?
Correct.
Help yourself to a cheese. Though by the looks of you, it would appear that you already have.
And a bit more besides.
Now, this must be the sidekick.
I'm no sidekick. I'm a professionally trained actor.
Oh, nice. Do you get much work? No, I don't suppose you do you? I mean, there can't be much call for somebody with such a wide face.
Go on, Orso. Push off. You've had your fun.
Yeah. I must clear off. I'm fully booked tonight. Well, Anil, it's a nice place you've got here, mate, but I can't help thinking there's something missing.
What's that then?
Customers. Tell you what, if ever you think of selling up, I might take this place off your hands. I'll give you a good price.
And I'll give you a good hiding if you don't clear it off.
And you won't get a better offer.
Neither will you. Now, there's the door. Use it.
I must say, that old also looks like a nasty piece of work.
He always has been. He's ruthless. He'll put me out of business. I remember the time at school when he pinched my conkers.
Sounds painful.
But this is no time for one of your dubious stories. Come along, Mr. Anil. You are indeed going back to school, but this time, cookery school. Let's go.
Great. I always wanted to do this. I have not got a wide face. Very funny.
Wow! Look at this place.
So clean.
What is it?
This, you might be surprised to learn, is called a kitchen.
Nah.
Or more precisely, the professional kitchen of my old pal, the showbiz chef, Ainsley Harrico. You are going to learn from the master. Oh, look sharp! Here comes Mr. Kettlecock.
No. Lovely, lovely. Well, here I am, right on cue, and always happy to help out a mate too. Now, watch yourself there, madam. I'm cooking on gas.
Careful! You could have somebody's eye out with that.
Easy, easy, easy. Just get your snorkel around that. Lovely.
What are they?
These are herbs.
Well, give them back to Herb. They stink.
This could be a long lesson.
There you are. I'd like to say it's going well, but...
Now we're going to make some lovely fresh pasta, which we all know can be a bit fiddly.
You're not kidding, mate. This tin opener's a murdering devil. I nearly sliced my thumb off.
OK. Now for the fish course.
What? There, of course, is what teach you how to be a fish.
Is he having a laugh?
Well, he'll be the only one that is.
You do know what a fish is, don't you?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Don't be daft.
Okay, okay. Well, name me your favourite type of fish then.
Fingers. Now, remind me, where do I shove this?
I'll tell you where you can shove that. You can shove that.
That was lucky.
I think that went really well. I can't wait to get back behind the wheel and start cooking again. How does beans on toast sound?
In your case, that's potentially lethal, but go on, do your worst.
Now let there be light.
Anil?
Basil?
You didn't by any chance take a booking for a plague of rats, did you?
No. We were going to be quiet all evening.
Yeah, quiet as a mouse. Or should I say, quiet as a rat.
What are you doing here?
Well, certainly not eating, and nor will anybody else be by the looks of things. If the council saw the state of this place, they'd close you down on the spot.
Why, you!
Hey, steady, Anil. I wouldn't grass up an old mate. No, I'm here to help. So my offer to take this place off your hands still stands.
It's a rat trap.
You think about it.
And you've been caught.
And so it really seems that Mr. Anil has burnt his last burger, stewed his last tea bag, and scorched his last salad.
It just won't be the same.
No. Maybe this also will cook some decent grub, eh? Look, I don't write it. I'm just a kid. Don't even think about what I'm saying.
I'll let you into a little secret. Neither do I.
Hey, do you lot mind? Right now, as we speak, poor Mr. Anil is just about to sign over the cafe to this slime ball. Also.
Well, I see you dressed for the occasion. Very appropriate. Going down with a sinking ship, are we?
Do you mind if I said a few words?
Go on if you must.
Cheese, sofa, buzzard, radish.
Yeah, yeah, all right, just get on with it, will ya?
I haven't got Ben.
You do know how to spell your name, don't you?
What do you think I am? Stupid? Begins with a B.
Yeah, that awful Admiral's outfit. What is he thinking? He's usually so cool. Sorry.
There must be something we can do to stop this also taking over.
Basil, surely you can think of something.
Greg, I've thought of something.
Yeah? Yeah?
What?
Spoons.
Spoons?
Sorry.
But it's all I can think of.
Nope. I'm very much afraid that we just have to face up to the cruel facts of life. Anil is scuppered. It's over.
Hey, come on. You know what they say? It ain't over till the fat lady sings. Okay, it's over.
Not necessarily.
What?
Well, I came across a surprise or two in the course of fixing the flashback machine, which I have to say was quite a tricky job.
Oh, really?
Yes. You see, the beta nodules had overloaded and shorted the capacitor coils completely.
Oh, do put a pencil in it and just tell us
about these surprises.
Well, I accidentally flashed back to late last Friday night and came across this.
The Basil Brush production office.
Who's that working late? Can't be the writer. He's under curfew and has to be back at the hostel before.
When the producer can't type.
Who is it then?
Also!
And then Anil's. And then Anil says this is a cafe, not a dentist. Now op it. R-A-T.
The rat!
An Admiral's costume. That'll be a nice touch.
So, it was all down to Orso.
Yes, he's quite literally the author of Mr. Anil's downfall. What's your name?
Trevor.
Mr. Trevor, can your machine flash me third ways to Anil's?
Oh, well, it wasn't designed for the job, but I could try cross-patching the flange fibrillation unit and de-scoping the arbiter distorter.
Let's walk.
Too late!
Nice one, Anil. I take that, and you take this. 50 quid, wasn't it?
Yeah. 50 quid?
Not a bad price, considering. Dave, this is Anil's whole life we're talking about.
From 50 quid, I don't change.
Ow!
You lot won't recognise this place soon, largely because of the sign I shall put outside. Awesome. Orsos. And before you say anything, you're barred. Because I won't have vermin in my cafe.
Vermin? Ooh!
Technically, he is quite correct. Foxes are officially classified as vermin.
And to think he's got a day off school for this.
Right. Let's get rid of some of his junk.
Oh, Anil, I'm so sorry.
We all are.
Yeah. Aren't we, Dave?
Yeah, of course. But maybe Orso will take the place up market a bit.
I'd take him up the market,
but I doubt we'd get much for him.
What will you do, Anil?
Where will you go?
Oh, don't worry about me. As it happens, I found myself a new job.
A new job?
Yeah, they said they were very lucky to get someone with my outstanding qualifications, unique experience in a highly specialist area.
But apart from making consistently disgusting and dangerous food, you can't do anything.
Dave!
Ow! Wait till I tell my mum.
No. Dave's hit the cockroach on the head, as it were.
Hey?
You see, they said that being one of the world's leading authorities on foul food, who better than me for the new food hygiene inspector of the local council?
What happened to the old one?
One of my pies. Anyway, I better get started.
Oh, nice outfit. You look good in leather.
You like?
Me like. It says, I'm Anil and I've come to inspect.
Yeah,
It does, doesn't it? Anyway, I should be inspecting. Oi! Fatso! On the subject of vermin, I hear you got rats, mate.
No, you've got rats, mate.
Leave it.
As of 1 minute ago, you became the proprietor. So I think you'll find you got rats, mate.
Or should that be checkmate?
Ha, 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 boom, boom. Oh.
Which means you got rather a large fine to pay. Or you can go to prison.
Nice to see him happy again. Well, it's nice to see things back to normally.
Hmm. Yep.
Oh, this food isn't fit for a pig.
Hang on. I'll go back in the kitchen and make you some that is.
Though maybe not quite so nice for the customers, eh?
There we go. And before you ask, it's on the house, yeah? By way of a little thank you.
You shouldn't have bothered.
I think we all agree with it.
What is it?
Oh, it's just a little something I improvised using only the freshest ingredients. Now tuck in, eh?
Actually, it's not bad.
Not bad at all. Quite tasty, really.
Mm. Well done, Anil. Very nice.
Oh, thank you. There's plenty more where that came from. I got a huge pot full out the back.
Here, Anil, how did you get rid of all them rats in the end, eh?
It's a rat trap. And you've been
another half hour of value for money television tucked safely under our showbiz belts, eh, Mr. Stephen?
If you say so.
Oh, here we go.
Look, I'm just sick of all the wide-faced jokes, all right?
There was only the one today.
An old woman stopped me in the street the other day and only tried to measure my head.
And did she succeed?
No, she did not.
Ran out of tape, I suppose.
It's not funny, Basil. My mates have picked up on it. You want to hear what they call me?
Yes, well, we all know school children can be very cruel.
Right.
Oi.
Look, Mr. Stephen, if it makes you sleep any easier in your specially reinforced pillow, I do not think you have an unnaturally large noggin.
Really?
Really. Now, go to sleep. Oh, by the way, I hope you don't mind, but I gave your tatty old baseball cap away to some Boy Scouts the other day.
Hmm. Okay.
They said it would do the job perfectly.
Good. What did they want it for?
Apparently they're going camping, and we're short of a tent.
Boom, boom!